Good morning, everyone. This is Shyam, Assistant Professor in Civil Department, Chabrol Engineering College, Subject Geotechnical Engineering 1, on topic Effective Stresses of Capillarity and Seepage Through the Soils. We discussed previous class in capillary tubes and different layers means stratums. So next topic is the effective of water table and continuation of the previous class. Effect of water table, fluctuations of effective stresses. So in this figure shows layers of soil system consisting of the soil 1 and soil 2. So here soil 1 and height of is the h1, and soil 2 is the height h2. This is the xa axis, and soil b is the soil 2 means cc, and bottom axis is the cc axis. Here in case 1, when water table is below cc, so below the water table cc, when condition the total neutral and effective stresses at A. And here soil 1 is the dry, soil 2 is the dry. Here sigma A is the 0 and U equal to 0. Then finally effective stress is sigma bar equal to sigma A minus UA, that equal to 0. It is the total stress sigma A, and neutral stress is the U, and effective stress is the sigma, that equal to 0. And next one is the total neutral and effective stress at BB. So this is the BB portion. Here total stress BB is the gamma D1 H1. So means right gamma D1 H1 and neutral stress is 0. Then finally effective stress sigma bar equal to total stress minus neutral stress sigma B minus UB, that equal to gamma D1 H1 minus 0, that equal gamma into D1, gamma D1 into H1. It is the second case 2, case 1 in second portion, and third one is the total neutral and effective stress in last layer CC section. Sigma C equal to gamma D1 is the gamma T2 H2. Sigma C is equal to gamma D1 H1 plus gamma D2 H2, and neutral stress is UC is 0. Then finally effective stress sigma bar equal to sigma C minus UC, that equal gamma D1 H1 plus gamma D2 H2 minus UC means 0. Then finally sigma bar means effective stress is gamma T H1 plus gamma D2 H2. This is the case 1 when water table is below CC. Next, case 2 is the one water table is at BB. So here water table is at BB line. Then here also find out the effective stress at AA and B and C. Then the total and neutral and effective stresses at AA, sigma A is the 0 and U also 0. Sigma A means total stress, U means neutral stress is 0, and effective stress sigma A equal to sigma A minus, so sigma A bar equal sigma A minus UA, that equal to 0, means A is 0, sigma and UA is 0. 0 minus 0, that equal to 0. Similarly, at BB, the total neutral and effective stress at BB. Sigma B equal to, at BB means this portion, here gamma d1 and h1. So sigma v equal gamma d1 and h1. UV is in neutral stress equal 0, and sigma bar equal to sigma b minus UV means total stress minus neutral stress. Total stress is the gamma d1 into h1 minus UV 0. So gamma d1 h1 minus 0, that equal to gamma d1 h1, and total neutral and effective stress at CC. Here gamma d2 into h2. So here both of two adding, gamma d1 h1 plus gamma d2 into h2 means saturation 2, that is called UC. Also saturation means in gamma w h2. So then finally gamma sigma c equal to sigma c minus UC. Sigma c is gamma d1 h1 plus gamma saturation 2 into h2 minus UC. Neutral stress is gamma w into h2, that is called finally gamma d1 h1 plus gamma saturation h2. So gamma dash h2. So gamma dash gamma saturation minus gamma w. So gamma dash here, gamma dash h2. Next, case 3, when water table is at ground level, that is at A. It is ground level when taken AA. First case is taken CC, and second case B, and third case is the case 3. AA is water table at taken ground level AA. So here also taken total stress neutral and effective stress. At A, sigma A is 0, and U also neutral stress is taken 0, and sigma bar A equal to sigma A minus UA, that equal to 0. And B is the total neutral and effective stresses at B. Sigma B equal gamma saturation 1 minus H1. So here gamma saturation files, and UB equal to gamma W1 H1 means unit weight of water in neutrals. Then finally sigma bar B equal to sigma B minus UB. Sigma B means gamma saturation 1 into H1 minus gamma W H1, that equal to gamma saturation 1 gamma W into H1. So here saturation minus gamma W means gamma 1 dash into H1, where gamma 1 is the submerged unit weight for the soil 1, and total neutral and effective stresses at CC. Here gamma sigma c equal to gamma saturation 1 into h1 plus gamma saturation 2 into h2. So here it is taken CC portion. So here adding 1 and 2 saturations, and UC equal gamma w into h1 plus h2. Here sigma c bar equals sigma c minus UC. Sigma c is the this value, gamma saturation 1 plus into h1 plus gamma saturation 2 into h2 minus gamma w into h1 plus h2. Here gamma saturation minus 1 gamma w in taken common 1 and 2. Then finally gamma 1 dash into h1 plus gamma 2 dash into h2, where gamma 1 is the submerged unit weight of soil 1, and gamma 2 is the submerged unit weight of the soil 2. Next case 4 is the when water table is above the ground level. So here CC at taking ground level and B taking ground level and A taking ground end and above the ground level vertebral. So here vertebral HW, here is the H1 and it is H2. Same similarly in this we find out the total, neutral and effective stresses. First of all, we find the case for total and neutral and effective stress at AA. Sigma is the overburden pressure due to the water column of the HW. Height equal to gamma W into HW. UA also gamma W into HW. Sigma bar A equal to sigma A minus UA. So substitute gamma W HW minus gamma W HW, that equal to zero stress, means effective stress. And B is the total and neutral and effective stresses at BP. Sigma B equal to gamma W into HW plus gamma saturation 1 H1 plus gamma saturation 2 H2. UB equal to gamma W into HW plus H1. Sigma bar B equal to sigma B minus UB. Sigma B equal to, that is gamma W dash HW plus gamma saturation 1 into H1 minus gamma W HW H1, it is the U value substitute. Then finally gamma 1 dash into H1. And third one is the total, neutral and effective stresses at CC. CC is the is taken CC portion 1 plus 2 plus 3 while is gamma W HW plus gamma saturation 1 into H1 1 and saturation 2 into H2. Then you see also gamma W HW plus H1 plus H2. Then finally effective stress sigma bar C equal to sigma C minus UC. Substitute the sigma C value and UC value. Sigma C value is and UC value is substitute. Then finally gamma H dash into H1 plus gamma 2 dash into H2, where gamma dash is the submerged unit weight for the soil 1, gamma 2 dash is the submerged unit weight for the soil 2. These are the four cases. One is the water table at sea, and two is the B, and water table at sea, and above the water table, ground level. And next topic is the seepage through the soils. Seepage is the flow of water under the gravitational forces in a permeable medium. Flow of water take place from the point of high head to the point of low head in one dimension flow where Darcy's law is varied. The velocity of flow is taken constant at every point over a cross section normal to the direction of flow. However, maybe the practical situation like flow through earth dams, sheet files, the flow of water is not and directional and velocity of water does not remain constant. In such cases, the quantity of seepage and other parameters such as the hydraulic gradient and pore water pressure are estimated by the help of flow nets. The concept and construction of the flow nets are based on Laplace equation of continuity. Next one, the type of heads. In seepage flows, there are three types of head variable in fluid flow. One is the velocity head and pressure head And third one is the datum R, elevation head. So first one is the velocity head. It is equal to the V square by 2G. Since laminar flow occur during the seepage and velocity is very small during laminar flow, hence in seepage analysis velocity head may be neglected. So velocity head means it is equal to V square by 2G. Next one is the pressure head. It is equal to the P by rho W. If a piezometer or an open stand pipe is inserted at a point of flow, water would stand at a particular height inside the piezometer. The actual height of the rise of water column in piezometer represents the pressure head. Next one is the third one. Datum or elevation head. It is represented by the jet. The elevation or datum head at the point is that vertical distance of that point measured from the an assumed datum. Generally, datum is assumed to the tail water level. Next one is the total head. Total head is equal to the velocity head plus pressure head plus elevation head. So these three heads are, it is equal to the total head. Hence, here total head is equal to 0 plus P by rho W plus Z. If we insert the standpipe at a point of flow, the elevation of the water level in standpipe with reference to the datum is equal to the total head. In seepage analysis, velocity head is the neglected. Here, total head and piezometric head both are equal. So means total head and piezometric head are equal. Head loss. The difference in total head between two point in soil through which flow is occurring represented by the head loss during the flow between these points. The total head is assumed to the reduced during flow. It is a seepage pressure and effective stress. Here, see the figure. Observe that it is the area A and seepage pressure in soil and length is L and water level datum H1 equal to H. Seepage pressure, when water flows through the saturated soil mass, it exerts the pressure over the solids by the vertex of viscous friction and referred as a seepage pressure. Hence, seepage pressure is the pressure exerted by the water over the soil solids in the mass through which it percolates. If H is the hydraulic, that is head loss, under which flow is taking place, then seepage is given by PS equal to H into gamma W. Also PS equal to H by Z into gamma W. Here Z into Z cancel, then we will become to H. and also it is written as PS equal to I into Z gamma W. I means H by Z. Okay, clearly. If A be the area of cross section, then seepage force is given by PS equal seepage pressure PS into A area. That equal to I. So here I into Z into gamma W substitute into in seepage pressure I into Z into gamma W into area. That here I into Z into A into gamma W. Z into A means volume, area into length, volume, that equal to I into V into gamma W. So seepage per unit volume is known as specific seepage force, which is given by PSS, specific seepage force, PS by V, that is PS is the I into V into gamma W by V. So here VV cancellation, that equal to I into gamma W. Here, seepage pressure always acts in the direction of the flow. Hence, vertical pressure means effective pressure at any given section is flow condition may either increase or decrease. Sigma bar equal to sigma bar plus or minus PS, where sigma bar equal to effective stress under no flow condition, PS equals seepage pressure under flow condition. So when no flow condition, the figure shows a tank filled with the submerged soil. Since the value at the base is closed, no seepage will be occur. So at layer section A, B, C. And height is Z, it is the water, ground level of water flow, and valve closed. It sections A at A, and section at C, and section at B, three valves, and heights of the three valves height and above the water content of H1. Here, total pressure and effective means total stress, effective stress, and neutral stress at A, C, B. Sigma U, sigma dash means it is total stress, neutral stress, and effective stress. Here, H1 into gamma W plus Z into gamma saturation. So here pressure head, datum head, and total head are tabulated are below. Points A, B, C. So first one, pressure head H at A. And at B, at B is the H plus H1, and at C also Z plus H1. Next, datum head at A, H, and B is 0, and C is H minus Z. And total head is H1 plus H, similarly B also H1 plus H, and C is the H1 plus H. Next one, total stress, pore water pressure, and effective stress are tabulated below. So point A and B, C, total stress sigma, gamma W, H. It is the gamma W H1. And at B, gamma saturation H into gamma W H1. And C also same gamma saturation H plus gamma W into H1. It is the total stress at points A, B, C. Similarly, pore water pressure U gamma W H1. And B is the H1 plus H in gamma W. Similarly, C at point C gamma W into H1 plus H2. Sorry, Z. It is the pore pressure, means pore water effective. Next, similarly, at point effective stress, sigma bar equals sigma minus U. So it is the sigma. And it is the U. It is a sigma bar. Then formula is the sigma bar equals sigma minus U. It is minus U. Then here sigma bar equal to at A gamma W H1 minus gamma W H1 that equal to zero. Similarly at point B, gamma saturation H plus gamma W H1 plus gamma W H1 plus H1, it is value negative in B. That equal here my plus gamma W H1 minus gamma W H1 is less. Then finally gamma saturation H plus gamma W H, that equal gamma dash H. So here minus, and at C point effective stress equal to total stress minus pore water pressure, then gamma saturation H plus gamma W H1 minus gamma W H1 plus Z. Then finally here less taken, cancellation. Remaining value is gamma saturation H plus minus gamma W Z, that equal to gamma saturation minus gamma W means gamma dash, that is Z into Z. The variations of sigma comma U and sigma bar are shown in figures. So it is the sigma and U and sigma bar. This is the variations in total pressure and pore water pressure and effective pressure, means head pressure, head total stress, pore water pressure and effective stress. Next one is the downward flow. Figure shows a tank filled with the submerged soil. Since the valve at the basin open and downward seepage is allowed, the downward seepage increases in effective stress. This is the figure shows. Here tank heads, or it is the water flow, and A point, C point, B point, heads tubes at A, C and B. It is the outflow, height H1 and H. And sigma is the F2, sorry, total stress, and U is the pore water pressure, and sigma is the effective stress. Here different cases, variations of sigma U and sigma bar with the depth downward flow. The total vertical stress at any point in soil mass is due to submerged weight of soil mass and seepage pressure depending upon the direction of the flow. Total stress, pore water pressure and effective stress are tabulated below. So here taking in figure, pressure head, datum head and total head are truly below. Point A and B, C. Pressure head at A, H1, this is and at B, H plus H minus H, and similar at C, HR plus Z minus IZ. This is the, and similar datum line H height, and B is the zero, means datum lines. The total height is, sorry, datum height is at C, H minus Z. This is H minus Z, and total height is present head plus datum head, H1 plus H2, and total head is present head plus datum head, H1 plus H minus H plus 0, that equal to H1 plus H minus H. Next one, total head present head plus datum head, H1 plus Z minus IZ, that equal to H1 plus Z minus IZ, means present head equal total head. Where small h is the hydraulic head, means head loss under the which flow takes place from the A to B, hydraulic gradient I equal to small h by capital H. The total vertical stress at any point of soil mass, is due to the submerged weight of soil mass and seepage pressure depending upon the direction of the flow. So here, total stress, pore mortar pressure and effective stress are tabulated below. Points A, B, C, and total stress at A and B, C. So total stress gamma, W into H1, and B at point total stress is gamma saturation into H into gamma W into H1. Similarly, C also same, gamma saturation Z plus gamma W H1, and pore water pressure U gamma W into H1, and at B, gamma W into H1 plus H minus 1, this is, and similarly at C, gamma W into H1 plus Z minus H1, and pore pressure water at C, gamma W into H1 plus Z minus IZ, and effective stress sigma bar equal sigma minus Q. So here, effective stress means total stress minus pore water pressure. So gamma WH minus gamma WH equal to zero. Next, similarly, at point B, gamma saturation H plus gamma W H1 minus gamma W into H1 plus H minus H. Then final value is the gamma dash H plus gamma W H. And at C, so total stress minus pore water pressure, that equal to final value is the gamma dash Z plus gamma W into IZ. This is the effective stress. The variations of sigma and U and sigma bar are shown in figure. In this figure, so next one is the upward flow. In this figure shows the value of the bottom of tank is open and upward seepage is allowed. So here phase figure, inflow, same inlet A at C, B, and height is C at Z, and B, H, and at A, H1. This is the water flow, it is H by 2 into Z. It is small. Head H is small H. Variation of sigma U and sigma bar with the depth of for upward flow. The figure shows value of at the bottom tank at open and upward seepage is allowed. At point A, at seepage flow. The total stress is at A, gamma W into H, and total stress is at B, H1 gamma W plus H saturation. Sorry, pressure ahead H1 and B is the H plus H1 plus H. And similarly, C is the H1 plus Z plus IZ and data mate is at point A, H. And similarly, B, 0. And data mate is at C, H minus Z. Then total head at A, H1 plus H, and H1 plus H plus H. And similarly, H1 plus Z plus IZ. Where H is the hydraulic head, head loss under which the flow takes place from A to B, and hydraulic gradient is the I equal to H by small h by H. Similarly, total stress and pore water pressure and effective stress are tabulated below. Total stress is sigma gamma W into H, and gamma saturation at B, gamma saturation H plus gamma W H. Similarly, at C is the gamma saturation Z plus gamma W H1. It is the figure in variations in total stress and pore water pressure and effective stress. Similarly, pore water pressure in at point A, gamma W into H1, and pore water pressure also at B, gamma W H1 plus H plus H, and C, gamma W H1 plus Z plus IZ. It is the Z. Similarly, effective stress is the total stress minus pore water pressure. Then gamma W H1 plus gamma W H, that equal to 0. And here B, total stress minus pore water stress. Then final value is gamma dash H minus IZ gamma W. Similarly, effective stress in at point C, gamma dash H minus IZ gamma W. The variations of sigma U and sigma bar are shown in figure also. These are the variations. So here, these are upward flow and downward flow, and also no flow condition. These are three conditions in seepages of soils. So any doubt in this session? Okay, thank you very much. Any doubt in this session?